السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته حياكم الله وبياكم وجعل جنة الفردوس مأوانا ومأواكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على إمام المرسلين وسيد المتقين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحابته الطاهرين الغر الميامين ومن اهتدى بهديهم واقتدى آثارهم إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، so my brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, we have finished with the risala of الشيخ العلامة صالح الفوزان الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى. May Allah preserve him. And so tonight, inshallah ta'ala, I'm just going to do general advice, general talk, inshallah ta'ala, to advise to myself first and to my brothers and sisters in Islam. And also, as everyone is, I believe, aware concerning the issue that has been raised 2 days ago or yesterday or today, many people have contacted me concerning the issue of Yasir al-Qadi, Yasir al-Fadi. And I will speak about him. And but before that, my brothers and sisters, just 1 second, as I mentioned, but sometimes I have to check my phone to make sure that everything is okay with the life. And other than that, نعم. So أيها الأحبة في الله، النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام ذكر في أحاديث عدة عن الفتن، بل قد ألف بعض العلماء كتب عن الفتن أو في الفتن والملاحم. My brothers and sisters, the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned many ahadith. There is many ahadith being narrated from the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam concerning al-fitan, trials and tribulations. And many scholars have authored books concerning the trials and tribulations that will occur before the end of time. The likes of al-Imam Abu al-Fida ibn Kathir, Ismail ibn Kathir, رحمه الله تعالى. And other than from the علماء. So my brothers and sisters, النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام has informed us and he has clarified everything to us. قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام كما روى أبو داود والترمذي وغيرهما عن العرباض بن سارية من يعش منكم فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين عضوا عليها بالنواجذ وإياكم ومحدثات الأمور فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. That the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Whoever live among you, you will see many differences. What is upon you to follow my way," mean the way of the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, "and the way of the Khulafa al-Rashideen, عضوا عليها بالنواجد, bite upon it with your mullet teeth." That shows you what? The fitna is going to be so much that it's going to be hard. You have to make sure that you hold unto the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, قال بدأ هذا الدين غريبا وسيعود غريبا فطوبى للغرباء. He said this deen started as something strange and will become as something strange. طوبى للغرباء, glad tidings. So it's called mentioned طوبى means glad tidings, or طوبى is a tree, that a blessed tree or tree in Jannah. طوبى للغرباء, طوبى glad tidings for the strangers, الغرباء. And they said, من الغرباء يا رسول الله؟ Who are the strangers? He said, الَّذِينَ يَسْتَقِيمُونَ عِنْدَمَا يَعْوَجِ النَّاسِ. There's other narrations. Those who go, who be firm, upright, in a time when the people choose to divert and deviate. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أيها الأحبة في الله علينا بقراءة أحاديث الفتن والمحن والملاحم ليستيقن الذين أوتوا الكتاب ويزداد الذين آمنوا إيمانا ولا يرتاب الذين أوتوا الكتاب وليقول الذين كفروا الذين آمنوا الآية نسيتنا لكن الشاهد بارك الله فيكم هذه آية ونرديس فتن ليستيقن الذين أوتوا الكتاب ويزداد الذين آمنوا إيمانا ولا يرتاب الذين أوتوا الكتاب. For those who has given scriptures to have certainty about that النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام is a true prophet, likewise about the Quran, يا ياسر القاضي. No, أنت ليس بقاضي, أنت فاضي حتى تتوب إلى الله جل وعلا. You are an empty person. That the Quran is the truth. So my brothers and sisters, for the believers to increase the iman. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, تعرض الفتن على قلب المسلم والمؤمن عودا عودا. That the fitan will approach the heart of the believer one after one. Some narrations mentions that every fitan will approach him, they will disappear. Or every fitan is about to approach him, he said, this fitan will destroy me. Then that fitan will not destroy him. The shaykh barakallahu fikum, the end of time, Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam, dakara lana. Wabayyana lana alayhi salatu wa sallam, satakthur fihi al-fitan. Satakthur fihi al-fitan. And Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam has clarified everything to us that the end of time, there will be a lot of trials and tribulations. فَمَاذَ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ. So what is upon the Muslim to do? كَمَا ذَكَرْنَا مِرَارًا وَتِكْرَارًا أَيُّهَا الْأَحِبَّةُ فِي اللَّهِ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ الْمُصْطَفَى وَالصَّفِيَّ الْمُجْتَبَى أَدَّى الْأَمَانَةِ وَنَصَحَ الْأُمَّةِ وَتَرَكَنَا عَلَى الْمَحَجَّةِ الْبَيْضَاءِ لَيْلُهَا كَنَهَارِهَا لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكَ. The Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام has clarified everything for us. He fulfilled the trust, alayhi salatu wasalam, and conveyed the message, alayhi salatu wasalam, and left us upon a clear guidance. It's day like it's night. Anyone that turns away from it will be destroyed. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ نَسْأَلَ اللَّهَ الْعَفْوَ وَالْعَافِيَةُ وَالسَّلَامَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. So, أَيُّهَا الْأَحِبَّةُ فِي اللَّهِ. So, the weird hadith of Al-Fitan, when you read a hadith of al-fitan, so you will not be surprised. Why? Because you think, I was expecting that. Why? Because as-sadiq al-masduq Abu al-Qasim alayhi salatu wasalam has informed us. As-sadiq al-masduq alayhi salatu wasalam has informed us. Look to the iman of Abu al-Hasan, may Allah please with him. When he fought against the Khawarij, some people started trying to put doubt in the army of Abi Talib that why are you fighting the Muslims? And he said, no, they are the Khawarij who deserve to be fought against. And he said, Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you will fight them. He told me, Ya Ali, you will fight them. And among them will be someone, his forearm will be cut off. Okay? And his forearm will be cut off. So he sent one of his companion to go and check. He looked, he came back. He said, I will fight. And they said, Abadan. He said, never. Prophet never spoke the lie. He never lied to me. Rather, he spoke the truth. He said, go back and check. He went back and he found him. He said, Sadaqa Abu al-Qasim alayhi salatu wasalam. Abu al-Qasim spoke the truth alayhi salatu wasalam. So my brothers and sisters, look how Ali ibn Abi Talib was certain. Liyaqeen. That's why we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our iman and to give us liyaqeen. And to not let us open our ears to the people of doubt and misconceptions. So, أيها الأحبة في الله, الله جل وعلا كذلك ذكر في كتابه الكريم عن فضل العلماء. أنا ذكرت الفتن ثم تنقلت ثم ثم ذكر أذكر الآن الفتن من العلماء أو العلم فضل العلم. السبب لأن في وقت الفتن علينا بالرجوع إلى العلماء الفضلاء النبلاء ليس إلى الجهال. Why I mentioned now about fitan, then now I'm speaking about virtuous scholars in the Quran, because in the time of trials and tribulations, upon the Muslim to go back to the scholars, not YouTubers, or someone who has million followers on Instagram or Snapchat or Facebook or TikTok or you name it. No. That's not the way. You go back to al-ilmi wal-fadli, the likes of Sheikh Fawzan, Sheikh Uthaymin died. You go back to their books to clear out your doubts. No one save from the doubts, misconception, or shaitan whisper to you. But you clear it out. You clear it out of doubt. Doesn't mean because if you believe you are, you're not going to face some unclear issues due to ignorance. That's it. The problem is not with the text. The problem with you have jahl. Or su'il fahm. Barakallahu feekum. The shahid, bismillah. The shaykh barakallahu feekum. Likewise, from the fitan, kama dhakar al Bukhari fi sahihi, mawt al ulama. Mawt, raf al ilm. And the Prophet said, yurfa al ilm. Kayf? Bi mawt al ulama. Knowledge should be raised. How? By the death of the scholars. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, al Sahabi al Jalil, likewise Abu Dar al Ghaffari. One of the great companions. He said, oh Muslims, benefit from your scholars now. It's going to come a time when there will be few scholars and a lot of Qurra. People that recite Qur'an don't understand it. Okay? And of course, Abdul Mas'ud al-Arda, one of the great Sahaba. Likewise, Abu Dharr al-Ghaffari. May Allah please of them all. The Shaykh Ayyul Ahibbatu Billah, the time of fitan, you go back to Al-Ilm, to scholars of Sunnah. Not the Orientalist, ليس إلى المستشرقين الذين همهم الكبير تدمير الإسلام والمسلمين. Not to the Orientalist, their main goal to destroy Islam and the Muslims, to make the Muslims the slaves of the Western world. No. Why? I will speak about الاستشراق, Orientalism. I will speak about it. الاستشراق وما أدراك ما الاستشراق. دئب كما يقول يلبس لباس ايش مثل احنا نقول لك الخروف. The wolf that wearing the cloth of the skin of the wolf. The wolf that wearing the skin of the sheep. So المستشرقون. The Shaykh بارك الله فيكم. My brothers and sisters, it's very important to learn and study. But not to learn from everyone, to learn from those of Allah's praise, the likes of the Sahaba, likewise their students, and their students, likewise the ulama. So the Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, dhakara Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, al-ulama'u warathatul anbiya'a, wal-anbiya'u lam yugarrithu dinaran wala dirhama, walakin warrathu al-ilma, faman akhadahu akhada bihaddin wafir. That the scholars are the inheritors of the prophets. And the prophets left no dirham, no dinar behind them, left knowledge. Whosoever has taken the knowledge has taken the great treasure. So, al ulama, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, likewise, my brothers and sisters, the Salaf understood the meaning of going back to the scholars and understood that the knowledge has to be taken from the. Not from any PhD. Abu Bakr never had PhD, my brother. Uthman ibn Affan never had PhD, my brother. Sa'id al-Musayyib never had PhD, my brother. Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani never had PhD, my brother. They become more later. Ibn Baz never had PhD, my brother. Al-Bani never had PhD, my brother. And other from the A'imatul Deen, Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Sheikh. Likewise, from the A'imatul Deen. PhD that will lead you to Jahannam. May Allah curse that PhD. May Allah save us from it. He's not a PhD. Imam Muqbil bin Hadi al-Wadi'i. May Allah have mercy upon him, of the Imam of our time. When he got one of the qualification from university in Saudi, he said, he ripped it. He said, now I have to start seeking knowledge more. Imam Abdullah ibn al-Ghudayyan, one of the great Imam of our time, he asked him about when he have when he been graduated from Medina University. He said that's when he started seeking knowledge. Allahu Akbar. Now you become amazing America. Yeah, Mufti Munir. And other than you, cutting off from the scholars while you people spreading doubt about Islam. Wal-iyadu billah. The shaykh, barakallahu feekum. Let's go back to the main point here. Khalas, we have to speak the truth to defend the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To know that we've been saying that for many years. My teacher's been doing it for the last 20 years. We have to refute the people of innovation, misguidance. Those who try to claim that upon the sunnah while destroying the Muslims. May Allah bless you all, my brothers and sisters. The shaykh, barakallahu feekum. So the scholars and the self understood it. That's what Ibn Abbas used to direct people to take knowledge from Sa'id al-Jubayr. Likewise from Mujahid. Likewise, Abdullah ibn Umar used to advise people to take knowledge from Atab bin Abi Rabah. And likewise, the ulama, Imam, ذكر Imam Muslim في صحيحه عن ابن سيرين أنه قال إن هذا العلم دين فلينظر أحدكم ممن يأخذ دينه. This knowledge is a deen. Be aware who you take your deen from. That's what Ibn Abbas, may Allah please with him, when the fitan started, fitan mean are the king of Uthman, radiallahu arda. And the Shaykh, barakallahu feekum, when the Quran was compiled at the time of Uthman ibn Affan, no Sahaba opposed him, as Ali ibn Abi Talib said. All this narration about Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, other than that, ulama dealt with it. Okay, ulama dealt with it, alhamdulillah, there was ijma' upon the Quran, without any doubt. I will come to Quran later on, inshallah ta'ala. The Shaykh, barakallahu feekum, Abdullah ibn Abbas said, to someone told him, Ibn Abbas, the messenger of Allah said, Ibn Abbas did not want to listen to him. He said, oh Ibn Abbas, I'm telling you the messenger of Allah said, are you not listening? He said, before the fitna, I mean before the king of Uthman, because now groups appear, people start lying. He said, we used to open our ears. Now, سَمُّوا لَنَا رِجَالَكُمْ. Name your men to us, who are you? مِمَّنْ أَخَلْتَ الْعِلْمَ مِمَّنْ يَعْرِفُكَ يَا أَخِي. Who are you? Who knows you? Who do you take knowledge from? Barakallahu feekum. PhD? PhD doesn't mean nothing. Barakallahu feekum. The Shaykh, likewise, Muhammad ibn Siri, said, this knowledge is a deen. Where do you take knowledge from? That's why the Imam Salaf, they used to put the index inside their ears when the Al-Bida used to approach them. To not put a doubt in their heart. This Imam, subhanAllah, what about us? May Allah protect us and save us from the fitan. Likewise, my brothers and sisters, so, it is very important. Don't be deceived by someone who has PhD. Let alone, actually don't be deceived by someone who has PhD from even Medina University. Let alone has PhD from Yale University. Yale University. Jamia Istishraqiyya, my brother. Orientalist University. Before I talk about it, let me go back to the main point because I don't want to digress again. The shared barakallahu feekum, brothers and sisters, let us take knowledge from the correct people. Analyze. Bik Sheikh bin Baz, bin Uthaymeen, Al-Albani, Fawzan. Of course, some names I'm going to mention now, it's very sad my brothers and sisters in Islam don't know them. Hamad Al-Ansari, Hamoud Al-Tuwajri, Muhammad Al-Ibrahim Al-Sheikh. May Allah have mercy upon them. A'imma, Abdul Hamid bin Badis, Mubarak Al-Mlili, one of the scholars of Algeria. Muhammad Amin al-Shinqiti, Taqiyuddin al-Hilali al-Maghribi. May Allah have mercy upon them all. We don't know them. It's ajib, they are the aim of the deen. They are the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and the likes of them. بَلْ هُوَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ وَمَا يَجْحَدُ بِآيَاتِنَا إِلَّا الظَّالِمُونَ. Quran, it is distinct verses within the breast of those who have been given knowledge. Yes, my brothers and sisters, that's the one you go back to. يَرْفَعُونَ عَنَّكْ شُبَهْ. No, they remove doubt from your heart. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى. They are the atibba' of al-qulub. As Ibn Qayyim mentioned, they are atibba', of course, the doctor of the heart is the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. But it's permissible to say the atibba', because some people will say, Sheikh Fawzan said this. So understand the speech of Al-Ilm correctly. Barakallahu feekum. The shaykh is the doctor of the heart is the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. But you love to say it's tabib, so and so tabib. Atibba', why? Because they are using the medicine, the Quran and the Sunnah. Barakallahu feekum. So my brothers and sisters, Learn our time, learn your deen. And again, my advice to you, my brothers and sisters, learn your deen, not by just going to Twitter, reading one quote, another quote, or listening to doubt. As I mentioned, some brothers and sisters, may Allah forgive us and them, and may Allah protect us and them from the evil of this life and the hereafter. Their heart is like a bin. Just put rubbish in there. Meaning putting just doubt in their heart. Why you open your ears? Learn your deen correctly, learn the usul. Man dayya al-usula hurim al-usula. Whoever has abandoned the usul will be deprived from reaching his goal. Or understand the deen correctly. عندما يكون عندك الأصول ترد على الشبهات بإذن الله جل وعلا. When you have the usul, be strong enough بإذن الله جل وعلا to refute the doubt. So my brothers and sisters, as I mentioned, how the knowledge has to be taken from the correct people, the likes of the scholars of our time, likewise the student of knowledge. So the Ula Ibn Abd al-Barr, may Allah have mercy upon him, Ibn Abd al-Barr, one of the scholars of Al-Andalus, they used to call him Bukhari al-Gharb, Imam al-Bukhari of the West, because he was from Andalus. طيب. And he said, not anyone say who is a scholar, layman, yes, a father scholar, so and so is scholar, no, it's for the ulama, the Rabbaniyun, the likes of Ibn Baz, Albani, Al-Uthaymeen, Fawzan, Al-Abbad, Rabi', Ubayd, this Imam of Deen. Now he's bringing some clout on YouTube. Yesterday I was doing social, what they call it, experimentation. Today I become alim. Shahad al-la'ib. What's the joke in our time? The Shaykh barakallahu fikum, my brothers and sisters. Likewise, from the I want to mention one hadith. Undeniable prophecy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the signs of the hour. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said from the signs of the, from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about a group of people from a long hadith. Sheikh Fawzan used it. There's other ulama used it. The Mashayikh. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said yaqdur rajul. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw a group of people getting punished. He said, ya Jibril, why are they getting punished? He said, because these people or this man, he will leave his house first time. By the sunset, he makes up a lie. But before he leaves his house, but before the sun rises, his lies reach the east and the west. This hadith is al-Bukhari. Sheikh Fawzan, I was listening to yesterday. Sheikh Fawzan, he said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaking about social media. Allahu Akbar. Because the Allahu Akbar, you know. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yaqdu fi al-lugha, the person that leave his house, has been explained, from Fajr to before sun rises. Actually, like 2 hours. Prophet said, so this person will make up a lie. تبلغ مشارق الأفاق. Sheikh Fawzan, الأفاق mean the far east and far west. The hell rising. How is it going to happen? Sheikh Fawzan even said, people saying, how is it going to happen? People say, like, how is it going to happen? Prophet, what are you saying? Allahu Akbar, look, social media now. Is that المؤمنون إيمانا? The believers will increase their hearts. The Nabi sallallahu spoke the truth. The lies, doubt and misconception. Social media is being used now by Islamic haters to spread doubt and misconceptions against Islam. And some Muslims are being used as tools to spread the lies and deceptions and doubt against Islam. The Shaykh barakallahu fikum. So if this is the case, who are scholars of our time? As I have mentioned, scholars of our time to go back to. I've been doing it in the last 3 years in the park. I've done it in many channels. Sheikh Ibn Baz, he died, rahmah ta'ala. But I'm saying, go back to their works. They are a'imma. You can trace back their scholars until Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Likewise, their aqidah, their manhaj is Quran Sunnah. Imam Abd al-Aziz Ibn Baz, Imam Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, Imam Muqbil Ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i, Imam Abdullah al-Ghudayyan, Zayd Ibn Hadi al-Madkhali. I'm going to mention Allah, Allah, Imam, just mention, okay? Because they are Imam as well, without any doubt. What do they call it? Ahmed ibn Yahya al-Najmi, al-Wassabi, rahimahu ta'ala, Abdul Wahhab al-Wassabi, one of the scholars of Yemen, died, rahimahu ta'ala. Hamad al-Ansari, Hamoud al-Tuwajri, and the likes of, likewise in, what do they call it? Taqiyuddin Hilali, I mentioned him. Muhammad Amin al-Shinqiti, Muhammad Aman al-Jami, may Allah have mercy upon them. Likewise, the Omar Fellata, one of the great scholars of Islam from Nigeria. Abdul Razzaq al-Afifi from Egypt. Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab al-Banna, No, Hassan al-Banna, there's two, even Hassan al-Banna, there's two. Yes, Hassan ibn Abdul-Wahab al-Banna, one of the scholars of Egypt, is still alive. He's nearly 100 years, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala. And there's his brother, Muhammad ibn Abdul-Wahab al-Banna. He died, rahimah Allah ta'ala. He's older than his brother, he's a teacher of Sheikh Bia. Likewise, so it's from Egypt as well. It's because of Egypt. May Allah have mercy upon them. And our time, you have mashayikh, scholars, and students of knowledge. The likes of Sheikh Rabi', Sheikh Ubaid, Sheikh Abdul Hussein Abbad, Sheikh Abdul Aziz al-Sheikh, Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh, and other Sheikh Saleh al-Haydan. And likewise, you have the mashayikh in Algeria, Sheikh Abdul Ghani Uwisat, Sheikh Abdul Hakim Dahas. You have in the mashayikh in Yemen, you have the mashayikh in Egypt. So now, I want to focus more in the West. Who are people that you look at their da'wah, they've been upon the same da'wah for the last two decades or more. More, 30 years. You know, some as maybe it was 3 years old or 2 years old, some as it was not even born. They are upon the same way, being praised by the ulama, alhamdulillah. And look at their works as well. Because sometimes some ulama praise him, but after deviate. Look at their works. The likes of our teacher, who these teachers, alhamdulillah, they won Angus Yasser al-Qadi, my brothers and sisters, 20 years ago, they won Angus Yasser al-Qadi. Abu Iyad, the Sheikh Abu Iyad Amrud Rafiq, may Allah preserve him, he said in 2000, or after that, he said, this person will Allah expose him more and more, and he will show his hatred to Al-Sunnah more and more. Rather, he's shown his true color, even against Islam, iyadu billah. Full of doubt. It's like you bring in a bottle of water full of dirt and you pour it. You want to wash yourself with it. That's how you bring it. Anyway, the Shaykh, my brothers and sisters, the likes of Sheikh Abu Khalija, Abdul Wahid, Hafidhahu Ta'ala, Sheikh Abu Iyad Amjad Rafiq. Look at their works, my brothers and sisters. These brothers, people lie against them, accuse them, slander them. These two individuals that came together two nights ago to slander these brothers and slander the scholars, look what they did. They caused a big doubt in the Muslim community. People contacted me, my phone doesn't stop, my brother says, I'm not one to be honest to come back to. I've tried my best to help you. But let us go back to Abu Iyad, Abu Khadija, Abu Hakim, all the scholars before that, without any doubt. Barakallahu feekum. Shahid, these are brothers for decades in the same da'wah. Aqidah, manaj, read the book of the Salaf. They're teaching Tawheed, Sunnah. When they teach, listen to their talks. And again, I will challenge Muhammad. Bring us the full audio of Abu Sheikh Abu Iyad. They believe that Sulaiman people magic. Kadim. You hear all his talks. Defending Sulaiman, alayhi salatu salam. But Allahu Akbar. Inna Rabbaka la bil mirsad. Wallahi, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Look how you wage the war against him, and look now how you've been big trouble amongst in front of the Muslims, promoting Yasir al-Fadi. Anyway, Sheikh Abu Iyad, and other than from the Mashayikh, of Sunnah, student of knowledge, Hassan al-Sumay in America. American brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all Muslims. Where on the earth you listen to this person, Yasir al-Fadi, and other than him? And you have, mashallah, well-grounded student of knowledge. The likes of Sheikh Hassan Somali, Musa Richardson, Omar Queen, Anwar Wright, Jamil Finch, and Kashif, what's his name? Abu Hafs, Kashif Khan, na'am. Hafidhahu Allah Ta'ala. People upon Sunnah for over decades, three decades, I think. May Allah preserve them. Same aqidah, same manhaj. Always refer people to scholars. But what I see now, people are united against them. But when you unite upon battle, Allah will expose you. Just as Muhammad Hijab and Yasir Fadi came together upon battle, Allah exposed them. The whole video, no one benefit except the doubt against the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We have sent the dhikr and we preserve it, Yasir Fadi. So my brothers and sisters, before I carry on about some advice I'm giving to myself first and to you, let me double check that it's working. May Allah bless you all. Alhamdulillah, it's working. So before we start talking about the istishraq, Orientalist, because one of the ways to remove the doubt about the Quran, Because you have to understand, this doubt is not coming from the Muslims. Okay, it's coming from the Al-Mustashriqoon, which Yasir Qadi himself admitted he studied under them. University, Yale University. He himself admitted that they deconstructed what he learned in Medina. And they fed him shubuhat. Awkam, who are the Mustashriqoon? Barakallahu fikum. The Shahid is, go back, my brothers and sisters, learn from the correct people, learn the aqidah, learn how the aqidah teach, the manhaj they teach. When they teach the people, they don't leave them with doubt, alhamdulillah. They teach you tawheed, sunnah, fiqh, lugha arabiya. They are in class, in our class, we have Arabic teachers, alhamdulillah. We have our brother Nordin, alhamdulillah wa ta'ala. We have brother Uthman, Sudani. For the beginners, we have brother Shamal. So we have lugha arabiya, even Birmingham. So we see the brothers where they're teaching. Not like these individuals, they're not teaching what benefit the Muslim. They're putting a doubt in the heart of the Muslims. May Allah protect us all. And we make dua for them, may Allah guide them. Even I make dua for Muhammad Hijab, Ali, and everyone make dua for them. May Allah guide them and guide us. Because at the end of the day, you don't want to see a Muslim being destroyed. No, you don't like that. You know what I'm saying? So the Shaykh, barakallahu fikum, we have to learn. That's why I keep advising my brothers and sisters. If you understand it correctly, you don't take Yasir Qadi serious. But why? Like, you know, the Christians are rejoicing. There's one guy's name, Shabir Ali. Shabir Ali, many people ask me about him a long time. I said, but don't listen to him. Doesn't mean because he's defending Islam, you have to listen to him. My brothers and sisters, listen to the advice of Imām al-Mubajjil, Abu Abdullah Ahmed bin Hanbal. He said, do not listen to the people of Kalam, even if they are defending the Sunnah. Why Abu Abdullah saying that Ahmed bin Hanbal? Because it's faqih. He knows that they're going to put doubt instead of defending Deen. You prove it necessary existence, they can just tell you, I believe the universe is necessary existence. Barakallahu feekum. When brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all, may Allah protect us and all of you from the evil of this life and the day after. When you see us and our teachers refuting individual personalities on YouTube, not because we don't hate Muslims, because we love good for the Muslims, we love the Muslims ummah, we want khair for the Muslims. But now when we start advising the Muslims, alhamdulillah, we're not talking about personal issues. We don't do that. Not like these other individuals. When we notice that, when the scholars or the student of knowledge notice that this individual is not listening, he's insisting upon his deviations, now we care about the ummah more than him. So we have to speak out openly to defend the ummah from his misguidance of aqidah and manhaj. That's how it is. Not because we wake up one day, let me think, who I want to attack today? Who I know? Who I want to backbite today? Let me think. So let me backbite him. How would you be there? How a person think like that would be there? You think about brothers in spam, celebrity publication. Wake up one day. Let me today think which school I want to drop. Sheikh Rabi, no, Sheikh Ubaid. No, let me do what they call in our country, Shadi Badi, play what they call it, gambling. No, it doesn't work like that. Alhamdulillah, for the last 30 years, they upon the same manhaj, same aqidah, alhamdulillah. Defending deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at their website about atheism.net, Sheikh Abu Iyad, about Isa alayhi salatu salam, about what they call it, Sharia. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam defending, and you come and lie against them. But because you lie against them and you slander them, Allah expose you openly to the whole world, bringing Yasir al-Qadi. Now let us speak about Yasir al-Fadi. Yasir al-Fadi, as I've mentioned, the student of knowledge has more than guessed him long time ago. The Muslims, if our Muslim brothers and sisters, may Allah bless them all, listened to our teachers and our scholars from day one, then those who are still affected by him, they will not take him serious. Like, for example, imagine I'm debating with Paperboy or Bob the Liar or any Christian, and he say, your Sheikh Yasir al-Qadi, I'll start laughing at him. I said, Yasir al-Qadi said what? Who's Yasir al-Qadi? You might just call a monkey to me. Or a donkey. How are you going to call? I don't take him serious. If you're going to tell me Yasir al-Qadi said there's a problem with Quran. Yasir al-Qadi. Yasir al-Qadi is a beast mouth of the Orientalists. I'm going to take him serious. He's your people. You fed him this poison. You fed him, not him to narrate to us. And you want to deceive us. No. Man al-Mustashriqoon, The mustashriqun now, about talking to Safari, alhamdulillah, Allah exposing him more. Now, Allah is showing that the brothers in Salafi publication and Troyd in Canada as well, forgot to mention our brothers, may Allah protect them in Canada, Troyd. Likewise, our brothers in America, they were right from day one when they exposed and refuted Yasir al-Fadi. And we make dua for the brother as well. We make dua for him. Because may Allah protect us, can happen to anyone, wal-iyadu billah. Why? He's self-amazed. You notice? He's even telling the scholars, look for your scholars in the local area. Not the local shop, go to the local shop. Look for the scholars in Canada. Or Jamaica, or France, or Ashanallah. Scholars unknown. You think just be tomorrow you got PhD as your scholar? Here's what he's saying. Yes, when he was in Canada, in Troyd or something, he said, look for the scholars in the, not Troyd, I mean, it was in Canada. Look for the scholars in the, in your local area. Hey, who is this shop cleaner we're looking for? In our local area? It's ulama, we're talking about ulama. Warath al-anbiya. And heads of the Prophet, my brother. You're not talking about some cleaner road sweeper we're looking for in the street. Look for shahada. But alhamdulillah, Allah raised. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Allah will raise those who believe among you by, and those who have been given knowledge by levels. So you go back to Al-Ilm. So what is the lesson that we take now from? The lesson that we have to take, that when a scholar, a student of knowledge, refutes someone with a clear-cut proof, then step back. Stop saying, Akhi, no, keep quiet. Well, you always refute everyone. He's not refute everyone because he feel like it. And stop lying, it's not a refute everyone. Barakallahu feekum. So my brothers and sisters, now the lesson we take from Yasser, anyone like Yasser, even that person, Omar Suleiman in America as well, same thing, this person. The stuff that he comes out from his mouth, a'udhu billah. And like and people like him. What people say, you refute everyone. No, Musa Richards I haven't refuted. Hassan Somali I haven't. Anwar Wright I haven't. Jamie Finch I haven't. Abu Hafs Keshe Khan I haven't. There's our brother, I forgot his name, is Algerian brother. I forget, one of the students of knowledge. He's Ma'ruf in America. But there's our brothers, that the brothers, they know them. We haven't refuted them. We refute people that are quote-unquote liberal Muslim. Now, Ikhwa, I will speak about istishraq, even about this doubt of qira'at. Because alhamdulillah, I have a nice book in Arabic language. This is one of the nice books that was written, small risala, subhanAllah, called Al-Qira'atu fi nadar al-mustashriqin wal-mulhideen by Abdul Fattah Abdul Ghani al-Qadi, rahimahu ta'ala, one of the scholars of Egypt. Wallahi, the way he destroyed their doubt, the Orientalist, perfect way. Wallahi, when he finished, he said, Sadaqallah, inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra, وَإِنَّ لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We have seen them the dhikr and we'll preserve it. This small book, subhanAllah. If you know Arabic language, try to get it. He's very good in this bab of Al-Qira'at. في نظر المستشرقين والملحدين. Anyway, the share before go to... So who are the before go to Mustashriqun, brothers. So Yasir Qadi, he was invited by Muhammad Hijab. Muhammad Hijab is, I guess, quote-unquote, Islam liberal Muslims. Okay? He said we should not liberalize Islam. However, Yasir Qadi is one of them. But he's promoting him. Why? Because Yasir Qadi and Muhammad Hijab, they have a common enemy. Bismillah. Who is their common enemies? Ulama, the scholars of Sunnah, and the students of Sunnah. The last Shabu Iyad, Abu Hakim and Sparks and Troy and other than them. So Muhammad Hijab inviting him to slander and lie and accuse the brothers. But وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. Their plan, Allah plan, Allah is the best of the planners. Now, people, even Muhammad Hijab at the end, he said, you know, I believe that it will be fruitful, this discussion is going to be fruitful, or people will benefit from it. Brother, they haven't benefited nothing, to be honest. The only thing people are in their heads, in their minds, is a doubt that Yasir al-Fadi has vomited. Okay? So my brothers and sisters, look, subhanAllah. Because why? Both are coming upon batil. They're not coming for the sake of Allah. They're coming for the sake of the enemy of my enemy is my beloved one. Even there is one brother that's close to my hijab. He was telling me, no, he doesn't like Yasir al-Qadi. I said, "Akhi, take Allah, ya akhi, promote him." He said, "No. Recently, he WhatsApped me. I don't even mention his name." He said, "Akhi, I take back my statements." I said, "Why?" I was surprised. Then the Prophet Adam sent me the video when Yasser Qadhi vomiting his doubts and his doubts from where? From the Orientalists. So all Christians do not get happy because هذه بضاعتكم ردت إليكم. This, your product been returned back to you. I don't make it take on him, but it's the doubt that you taught him in your university and he's vomiting it to us. So don't try to use it as a scholar. Look, you see that? You see how the Orientalists are dangerous. They bring some Muslims, they feed them, and they say, go speak for Islam. Then when he speaks, say, look, he's a Muslim. No, brother. We're not deceivers and we're not a fox. And the fox will not deceive us. Bismillah. هذه بضاعتكم ردت إليكم. This your product being returned back to you. This your doubt that he's vomiting it. But now you try to use a Muslim to propagate it. To say, look, a Muslim saying it. No. Alhamdulillah. Shabir Ali likewise. He is not known to study under scholars. He studied in Canada. Canada, why? You said, Allah, la hawla wa quwwata illa billah. Now, mashallah, we stop listening to ulama, Imam al-Din in India, the scholars of India, the likes of Safiyyu Rahmat al-Kafuri, rahimahullah ta'ala, the likes of even Sheikh Wasil Abbas, one of the scholars, without any doubt. We're not going to say he's not a sheikh, he's not a scholar. But I have to mention it clear, as clear cut proof, where is Abu Khadija was wrong. Because he himself admitted that Abu Khadija, he never said it, but Abu Khadija was right concerning some issue that he was wrong. May Allah preserve him. The sheikh. So we need the scholars of big scholars and we're going to listen to people who studied in Oxford University to teach us our deen. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Anyway, so this is the general history, the summarized history of these two individuals. And look, they were going around. Ali needs da'wah. Ali da'wah. Muhammad Hijab. Haji, they're going. Sheikh Abu Iyad, they don't say Sheikh, they mock him. It's a meek Sheikh. He has to make tawbah openly. Muhammad, openly, I'll call you to make tawbah from promoting this guy. You are likewise I era promoting their channel. Wallahi, this amana. The Muslims are taking you serious. Wallahi, the mind of the Muslim amana in your hands. And you are feeding them with these people. Why? What happened to clarity? Ain al-haq. Why mixing the truth with falsehood? One, you have an Naqshbandi here, you have Dubendi, you have someone full of doubt here. Why? Why don't speak out against him, against Yasser al-Fadi? He's known to full of doubt. Ma'roof, he said it. There's many videos of him that the non-Muslims are using against Islam. Say, look, he has doubt to Sheikh. He's not my Sheikh, he's Batikh. He's a watermelon. He's not our Sheikh, alhamdulillah. He's never been and he's not. Alhamdulillah. So see, because you are waging a war against the brothers who are upon the truth, according to the truth, clarifying the truth, defending the truth based upon bodily doing it, look how Allah exposes you so quickly by promoting deviate person. Now we come to the Mustashriqun. Man hum al-Mustashriqun? Who are the Orientalists? The scholars differ concerning Mustashriqun when they started. Some of them mentioned, let me define Istishraq. Istishraq, the scholars from the Western world study about the Eastern world in general. Okay? More specific, the scholars from the Western world, the Christian scholars, the Jewish scholars, studying about Islam, more specific. What is their goal to study Islam? To cause confusion amongst the Muslims and to represent Islam in the wrong way. Even there is an Arab Orientalist. He mentioned that. I forgot his name, Said Edward. Yes, he mentioned that. He said that there's a lot of lies among the Orientalists in the West about Islam. Even I have a book, one of the scholars of India, may Allah have mercy upon him, died long time. He wrote a book about the Orientalists when they were translating in the 18th century, a Quran, how they were translating it. Lying. You know, subhanAllah. So Orientalists, some scholars mentioned, started at a time when the Muslims start mixing with the non-Muslims, with the people of the book. Some of them mentioned, no, it started where in Andalus. When the Muslim in Andalus started mixing with the non-Muslims, especially with the people of Castilla. And this is more specific at the time of Alfonso VI. When the French priest came to Spain, to the Muslim world, and he started studying Arabic and the Quran, and he went back to Italy, and he became the Pope. So he's the first person, I forgot his name. The Shia is, when the Western world came to invade the Muslim countries, they brought a lot of so-called Mubashiruna bi Jahannam, I call them, not so-called, they are Mubashiruna bi Jahannam. They're the Orientalists with the scholars or missionaries. That's it, missionaries with them to preach Christianity, like in France. When France came to Algeria, they brought with them many, many missionaries who claim that they know about the Quran and they're going to teach us Islam or tell us about Islam and teach us Christianity. Okay? And alhamdulillah, France stayed 132 years in Algeria. When we kicked them out, what was I saying? Muhammad mabruka alik al-Jazair raj'at alik. Oh, Muhammad, this day blessed for you because Algeria has returned back to you. I mean, they are Muslims, alhamdulillah. 430 years. France, then Algeria. They killed a million. There's no, this incorrect one, Algeria is the country of 1.5 million shaheed. No, more than that. Over 3 million shaheed, inshallah ta'ala. They are sure that inshallah ta'ala. Because we share inshallah, this is the aqidah. We don't know, it's inshallah. Okay? The shared barakallahu feekum. So now, when the Western world noticed that there's another way we have to use to turn the Muslims from their religion. By force does not work. Muslims are strong, they will fight back. Okay? For their country, to defend their religion. What they did, now we have a new tactic. What is a new tactic? All Muslims, your scholars, you cannot trust them anymore. We're going to teach you Islam. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Who's going to teach us Islam? Oxford University is going to teach us the correct Islam. Cambridge University is going to teach us correct Islam. And what is their motive? Is their motive to get us closer to Allah? No. What is their motive? To take us away from Islam. Even one of the Christian scholars in Algeria said, or to his students, he said, oh my students, if the Algerians doesn't accept Islam, just put a doubt in their hearts to leave Islam and let them be atheists. Because they know Izzah in our religion. They know if we leave Islam, we'll be humiliated. May Allah protect us, my brothers and sisters. Now, what is the best way for the Muslim to leave his religion? Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, doubt about him. Okay, now they start focusing on Quran. Makhtutat, manuscripts. One of them, the likes of Godzif, that's his, I forgot his name, correct name, but the Sheikh here, he refuted him. So one day doubt about the Quran, that the Quran, aslan, the reason of the different qira'at, different recitations of the Quran, because the Quran was written in the manuscript without dot, you know, without nuqta, dhamma, al-alif. So what happened? The Muslim didn't know how to recite it. So everyone started reciting it the way he thinks it's correct. Okay? That's one of their doubts. Wallah, how the Sheikh refuted it. I will mention the examples. The Sheikh, he mentioned there, no, qira'at is based upon what Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught with his companions. And how Prophet heard it from Jibreel, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not based upon ijtihad, because he's going to feel like it. And he gives examples. When I read it, by the way, I read it two times, alhamdulillah, or three times. So I'll give you examples, my brothers and sisters. So he said, let me mention this, one of the well-known Orientalists, was if he mentions his name here, I forgot his name. George Zahir. Okay, this person, he wrote a book about the Quran and even translated in Arabic language. So he said to them, okay, let me give you an example that the Quran, the recitation of the Quran, is based upon what the Sahaba heard from Sallam. Likewise, their students and their students, not based upon because they don't know how to pronounce the word, so let's not pronounce it a different way. No. He said, example, مثال أول كلمة مالكي. He said, ذكرت في القرآن على أنها صفة. He has mentioned the rulings. So there's three times been mentioned. In one verse, مالكي يوم الدين. في الفاتحة. سورة الفاتحة. قل اللهم مالك الملك. سورة آل عمران. ملك الناس. قل أعوذ برب الناس. ورسمت هذه الكلمة برسم واحد. The way it's been written, same way. Okay? However, he mentions here, وهو حذف الألف بعد الميم, which there is no ألف after ميم, mean ملك here, ميم لام كاف. Now, of course, they start doing it because now many people accept Islam and they don't know the rulings. Okay, they know the rulings, how to read. Or they have no study from teachers. I will speak about this issue. But let me give you this example, may Allah bless you all. So he said, if we just ask them to read it the way they like it, how come all of them agreed with Surah Qul A'udhu bi Rabbin Nas? All of them, all the recites agreed, Malikin Nas. Malikin Nas, not Malikin Nas. Even though if they read it Malikin Nas, will make sense. There's no problem with it. But he said, to show you here, Al-Qira'ah is based upon Tawqifiyah. Because in the other surah, they recited different ways. Why? Because Prophet recited different ways. Because Prophet Muhammad said, Unzil al-Qur'an ala sab'ati ahruf. The Qur'an was revealed upon seven ways. So he said, if we just ask them, how come they all of them unite upon the Qira'ah of Malikin Nas? Then he gives another example. He gives many, many, many examples. Wallahi, he humiliated him. He humiliated him. This book, my brothers and sisters, I'm not sure if this book it has been translated. But this book is a powerful book, even though it's small. How he humiliated this kadab and liar Orientalist who championed doubt about the Quran. Why are they doing that? Because firstly, they want us to turn away from our religion. And Allah mentioned that in the Quran. Allah mentioned that the people of the book want us to learn and leave our religion. And now Mustashriqun are coming from the angle. They claim that I study your book. Or Christian, or David Wood, or the other guy. If I tell you your Bible's been changed because there's a Muslim scholar said it, you will not take me serious. You will not take me serious. Even if I tell you a Christian scholar said it who studied in Islamic universities, you will not take me serious. So why would I take Yasser al-Fadi serious? See? But if the Bible has been corrupted, we can easily show you corruption in your Bible. I don't have to be a scholar to show you. I have different Bibles. Some passages there, some passages not there at all. So they think also the other reason, because they're not happy that our book's been preserved, so they want us to be like them. Because their book's been corrupted, even the layman Christians know that. But layman Muslims know the Quran has been preserved. So my brothers and sisters, al-mustashriqun, who Yasser al-Fadi studied under, their main target is to cause confusion and to misguide the Muslims. That's why they focus on the qira'at. And Yasser al-Fadi is not expert to speak about this issue. And please, brothers, those who tweeted about it as if conspiracy. Brothers and sisters, did you know this issue of qira'at is everywhere? You go to any maktaba, any Islamic bookshop, you see people selling the books normal. You don't go and say, brother, do you have the book of qira'at under the table, please? I want to. It's like a hidden secret. No. You can, anyone can have the books, go to any Islamic bookshop. It's ma'roof because from our deen. Rather, from the hikmah of qira'at, because the Quran was reviewed in Arabic language, and Allah challenged the Arabic speakers. And the Arabs had different dialects, different ways of speaking Arabic, different ways of taqdim al-fa'il or al-maf'ul, and other than that. Likewise, different pronunciations and different wording. Rather, the qira'at proved that Prophet Muhammad ﷺ received the Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because how man that lived in the middle of desert in Mecca was able to encompasses the dialects of the tribe of Tamir, tribe of Hudayl, tribe of Qahtan, tribe of Yemen, tribe of the people of the tribes of Arabs of Sham, and other than them. There was no internet for us to go to Google. Let us be realistic with ourselves. How he knew this, Lughat, alayhi salatu salam. Why? Because Quran was for everyone. For the old Arabs to challenge them to bring like, something like it. That's why Ubay ibn Ka'b, which was named misquoted, Ubay ibn Ka'b, no person told him Quran was revealed upon seven ways. He started having doubt. No. Ubay ibn Ka'b heard someone recite in different ways than him. He heard someone recite the Quran different ways than him. So he told him, the person said, recite. He said, that's how it was revealed. And that's how it was revealed. When Prophet ﷺ told him that both them, then the person Ubay ibn Ka'b brought him. Then Prophet ﷺ told him. Then he said, what is happening? So Prophet ﷺ said, oh Allah, remove the doubt from his heart. Or not doubt, the whisper. So that's it. No, Prophet ﷺ told him, I'm having doubt about it. No. When he heard someone recite the Quran, different ways, and he's the one who is narrating the hadith that the Quran was reviewed upon different ways. Ibn Khattab, to show his Sahaba from day one, want, made sure to protect the Quran. Ubay ibn Ka'b, he doesn't care. If he doesn't care, he would have just speaking, he didn't even say the way like this. No, he said, well, let me take Prophet. Take you to the one who reviewed the Quran. And he took him, he said, look, I was reviewed from this way. Same. Okay? Now Ibn Khattab, a tough man. He heard Ibn Hizam recite in different ways than him. He said, I was about to jump on him and drag him. So he waited for him, then he took Prophet. Prophet said, recite. We recite, he said, Unzil Quran ala sab'at ahraf. The Quran was reviewed upon seven ways, and over 20 companions or more recited the narrated the Quran was reviewed in different ways. Even Uthman ibn Affan on the minbar, for everyone, he said, stand those who know, for Salim said, the Quran was reviewed in different ways. Many companions stood up and testified for it. So, my brothers and sisters, if you want to learn about this issue, Qira'at, there's a way, alhamdulillah, rather. Qira'at increase your iman. As I mentioned, how man that lived in Mecca was able to come with this eloquency. As Al-Jazari mentioned, may Allah have mercy upon him. The shaykh is, the time of the Salaf, they were ijma' of the Qur'an. I'll give you an example. The time of Ma'mun, someone was a Khariji, rebelled against him. So he came, they captured him. So he said to him, why are you rebelling against me? He said, ayah fi kitabillah. He said, wa ma hiya? What is it? He said, Allah said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Whoever doesn't review by what Allah has revealed, they are disbelievers. He said, كَيْفَ تَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّا مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. How do you know it is from the book of Allah? He said, إِجْمَعَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ. The Muslims agreed upon that it's from the Quran. Subhanallah. Another one, when Ahmed al-Hanbal was debated with the Mu'tazila, he said, the Quran, all of us agree, the Quran, مُجْمَعَ عَلَيْهِ. So it's ma'roof, my brothers and sisters. My brothers and sisters, as I've mentioned in my debate and my dialogue many times, why the only book that has been memorized by 100 million of people word by word, letter by letter, is the Quran? Why? What is special about this book? Okay, why? Why is not the Bible? Bible is special to its people. Both the Torah and the New Testament, the Old Testament, the scripture of the Hindus. Why is the Quran only? And bear in mind, Allah mentioned that 1,400 years ago. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُذَّكِرٍ. The Quran will make the Quran easy to be memorized. So imagine, even at the time of Uthman ibn Affan, even at the time of Umar al-Khattab, when Umar al-Khattab asked Abu Bakr to put the Quran together in one book, he never put it to dispute it for the people, not to, for the Dawla. For the Dawla, and Uthman ibn Affan put up to the Quran. You know, by the way, I'm just mentioning these stories in general, okay? If you want to learn about more details, the ulama has written many articles, alhamdulillah, but there's a way to study it. And some of them, what they do, they make weak ahadith, weak statements, like the Orientalist, who ahadith that is sahih by they misrepresent it, and so on. Okay? The shahid and the Quran we have, that the same Quran was revealed upon Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, and Uthman ibn Affan compiled it. And the Quran was revealed in different ways. When Islam spread out, some people didn't know. So Uthman ibn Affan called Hudayf ibn Yaman, came to Uthman ibn Affan, he told him, people are different. Uthman ibn Affan got the Sahaba. He didn't get people came 1,000 years after Rasulullah, no, from a Sahaba who had the Quran directly from him, and compiled the Quran, again using the Mus'haf that was compiled by Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And Quran, and again, Quran, my brothers and sisters, is not about the book. No, Quran taken from the mouth. That's why when Uthman ibn Affan made 6 copies, he sent teachers with it to make sure you are pronouncing it correctly. That's why Qira'ah is what? Is Qira'ah has to be isnad to it. Make sure this how Rasul pronounced it. No, that's why they say it's principle. لا تأخذ القرآن عن مصحفي. Principle Islam. Do not take the Quran from someone who studied it from the book. No. Because you pronounce it incorrectly. No, from the ulama. And we have ulama, brothers and sisters, to make it clear to you. Imagine now, I tell you, or to make you understand, in every generation, there were hundreds, thousands of Muslims that were the Quran, or million, word by word, letter by letter. That's what you have to understand. Every generation, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam time, many Sahaba was Quran. Uthman at-Tabi'in, Atba'at-Tabi'in, and the Muslims, They were memorizing the Quran and reciting it openly. They were not doing it in like conspiracy in a hidden cave, not openly. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to say, when he's walking around nighttime, I know the house of Ash'ariyin. Ash'ariyin, who are they? The family of Abu Musa Ash'ari. Sahabi Jalil, okay? No, Ash'ariyin, the sect, okay? Ash'ariyin, the family of Abu Musa Ash'ari. The Shahida, openly. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to recite the Quran openly, in a masjid. Likewise, Sahaba, likewise, Tabi'in. So not like the Christianity, not like the Bible. So David Wood and other knew, don't you ever, never, and ever try to compare your book to ours. Please. Wallahi, it's like you comparing onion with apple. Seriously. It's not like, but I'm just giving an example, of course. We don't like the Quran to apple, but I'm just giving an example. The shared back in love, far away. Alhamdulillah, you Christian scholars, maybe they haven't even memorized one chapter from the Bible, let alone one gospel. Alhamdulillah, so we have scholars now, living scholars of Quran. Huffaz, Qurra, they have their teachers. No, they teach widespread. You know, widespread. So we don't rely on the manuscripts, Makhtutat Sana'a. And by the way, the manuscripts of Sana'a, there is a teacher, doctorate, is from Tunisia, or one of the countries, has written a nice book, Angaz Makhtuta of Sana'a, which they are. Which Shabir Ali doesn't know what he was talking about. First of all, he said it was a personal use. What is a personal use? That was not the Quran of the Dawla, of the state. Personal use, I remember when I was in school in Algeria, when we learned the Quran, you have a notebook, okay? You have a notebook empty. So you memorize Quran. For example, I'm going to memorize Al-Fajr. So I'll write the Fajr. Then I want to memorize what? Al-Baqarah. You say, I'll write Al-Baqarah. Then I want to memorize what? Taha. I'll write Taha. Now I want to memorize Surah Al-A'la, Surah Al-A'la. So imagine I die and people find my book 5,000 years later. We're going to say, oh look, the Quran has been changed. Because this book, he has a Baqarah after, before Surah Al-A'la, Surah Al-A'la. No, this is a personal use. When you have a personal mushaf, you're allowed to تقدم وتأخر. معروف هذه. But these Christian, these Orientalists don't know that. So they're looking for any doubt. And we don't take our Quran from a manuscript that has been found in under the sand or under the cave or inside the cave and believe in it. No. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, if we found mistakes in a manuscript, we don't bring the scholars and they say, you know, you have to follow the manuscript. No, we say we have to correct the manuscripts. We bring the Huffad, the Quran scholars, to correct it. Because the question we ask ourselves, who wrote that manuscript? Tell me. 1,000 years old, so what does that mean? I have to listen to it because 1,000 years old, but who wrote it? Was it even Muslim? Do you understand, my brothers and sisters? So alhamdulillah, our Quran been preserved in a perfect way. Alhamdulillah. The Quran that we're reciting today is the Quran that was revealed upon Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. But because you listen to doubt of the Orientalist, yes, Al-Fadi, now Muhammad Isha bring you to promote that doubt. And my brothers and sisters, of course, I'm not an expert on the Quran, alhamdulillah, but I have the foundation, alhamdulillah. I'm with the brothers, they are experts. I have the books, I studied, alhamdulillah. You know? And when you learn the qira'at, wallah, it's amazing how powerful the qira'at. Even there's a verse that explain another verses. Because why? There's no contradiction in the qira'at. There's contradistinction. What is contradistinction? Give you a vast meaning. Vast meaning. That's why there's no tanaqud in the Qur'an, abadan. Do you understand? So, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. As I will remember you, I will remind you again, if you are able, please try to get this book. I'm not sure if they translated it, but try to get it. This is a book, mashallah, tabarakallah. He humiliated Orientalists. Showed them how jahil they are. Even they in Arabic. Likewise, was named the scholar that he died, Muhammad Mustafa al-A'zami, one of the scholars of Quran, Maqtul Ta'ala Rahmahu wa Ta'ala. He mentioned, he said, when he was Oxford University studying, he's well grounded. Let me clarify something. I'm not saying it's haram to study in Oxford University or any university, but I'm saying if you're not well grounded and strong, then don't go to places like that. I'm talking about studying your deen. You don't study your deen from any university. Like when Azami, when he went to study, he's a person who's scholar in Quran. well grounded. Likewise, one of the scholars of India, Rahimahullah Ta'ala, died. One of the, he spoke different languages. What was his name? Abdul Hamid Ish. La hawla quwwata illa billah. He had fantastic works for defending Islam, defending the Quran, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I forgot his name, subhanAllah. Nasit, wallah, nasit. Anyway, shaykh, barakallahu feekum. Mustafa Al-Adham, he said, when he was in Oxford University, he says there was a teacher teaching Arabic language in Islamic studies. And he said to Mustafa Al-Adham, rahimahu ta'ala, he said, you know, I think the Muslims should ask us because we are Mufti, because we know Islamic teaching and we have Islamic knowledge. He said, that's when I remembered the statement of Muhammad ibn Sirin. Inna hadha la'ilma deen falyandur ahadukum mimman ya'khud deenahu. So when I remember the meaning, the true meaning, the powerful statement of Muhammad al-Sirin, this knowledge is a deen. But where you take a deen from? Doesn't it because you have PhD in Arabic language or PhD in Islamic studies that you got from Azhar or you got from university, then we have to take you seriously. The scholars have to praise your works and see who you are. You know, subhanAllah. Anyway, my brothers and sisters, I hope everything's clear to you. May Allah bless you all. So my advice to break into points, study your deen. Don't listen to anyone that because he has PhD. That's not the criteria. Go back to the scholars of Sunnah, those who are known. Go back to students of knowledge in the West who are known by the scholars. Not those who are here to please everyone. Barakallahu feekum. I have mentioned their names. And likewise, understand, read the Quran. And again, the Quran, when you read it and listen to it, ijaz of the Quran, the miracle of the Quran. There's many books written about the ijaz of the Quran. How someone 7 years old memorized Quran word by word, letter by letter? Why? Like, you think people, book like that will be lost? Will never be lost, inshallah. Book like that will never be lost, except, of course, the end of science. Our Allah will raise it. Okay, you understand that. But meaning will not be corrupted. That's why I'll finish the story. It's been narrated that Al-Ma'mun once was sitting, is Mu'tasim al-Ma'mun was sitting with a Christian in his palace. So he told the Christian man, become a Muslim. The Christian said, no, I'm happy with my religion. So he said, okay, no problem. So what happened, that Christian man, why did he start corrupting, he wrote Torah, okay, and he started changing stuff in Torah. Then he went to Jewish people in Iraq, Jewish scholars, and he started selling it to the people. He said, people start taking it, they even noticed that I've changed some stuff. He said, then I done it for the Injil. People start taking it. He said, I done it for Quran. I start some chapters or something. He start changing some words. So he said, I went to the market, to the Muslim market. He said, the layman Muslims rushed me, start beating me up. So what happened? Years later, he met with Mu'tasim again, or Ma'mun. So Mu'tasim said, you are so-and-so from last time. He said, yes. Did you become Muslim? He said, yes. He said, what is your story? He said, this is my story. He said, I knew the Quran would be preserved. If our Muslimin have noticed, and the scholars of the Jews and the Christians have not noticed that I've changed the scriptures, then this book is special then. Of course it's special. Go in our mosque. Imam make mistakes, 7 years old will correct him. Allahu Akbar! Ya Fadi! Ya Makhdool! You bring this and you start talking nonsense? خذلك الله جل وعلا لطعنك في علماء السنة كما قال ابن عساكر إن لحوم علماء السنة مسمومة وسنة الله في منتهكيهم معلومة. Poison the flesh of the scholars. Lying against the book of Allah before that. 7 years old. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى. You say something? No, we'll correct you. Woman will correct you. Ever will correct you. Allah Akbar. More is the Quran. Subhanallah. Every year, thousands. People graduate to be from Quran Institute, schools, hafaz, word by word, letter by letter. And that's how it's been the case from before and before and before. How Quran has been changed? Never. You see, subhanAllah, Allahu Akbar. As they said, if we threw all our books, let us throw all our books in the sea. Bible, khalas, bye-bye. Hindu, bye-bye, without any doubt. The only ones that are going to come back, Quran. bring 7 years old from Algeria, from Pakistan, from Somal, from India, from Europe. Please do it for us. Quick thing. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So have yaqeen, my brothers and sisters. May Allah bless you all. We stop here. We can trust our children to bring back the Quran to us by writing it. Because they're huffar. You can't even trust your scholars, Christians. We can trust our children, Muslim children, to bring back the Quran to us if we threw in the sea by writing it. You cannot trust your scholars to write down to write down the Bible. Because they haven't even memorized the chapter. Allahu Akbar. صدق الله بل هو آيات بينات في صدور الذين أوتوا العلم وما يجحد بآياتنا إلا الظالمون. Rather, it is distinct verses within the breast of those who have been given knowledge. والحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على خاتم النبيين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. بارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خيرا.